Hey, good Saturday morning. And technically, I got 2 minutes before it's Saturday afternoon. I just wanted to check in with you guys because I haven't made a good morning video for, three or four days now. And the reason I haven't, I had a friend of mine get in touch with me and ask me if I'd like to go four-wheeling. Excuse me. And I said, okay, what do you mean four-wheeling? Well, they got this little club up here, trails, and like, I don't know if it's 1,200 or 12,000 acres for four-wheeling. And I ended up going up there, and this person has a cabin up there, or a camp if you want to call it that, and ended up shacking up there for a couple nights, and just four-wheeling 2 or 3 days in a row, you know. I had an amazing time. I was introduced to this place about 4 weeks ago, maybe 5 weeks ago, by my buddy Jim. And ironically, another friend of mine, I find out, he's got a place up there, and he does a lot of four-wheeling. So I ended up going up there. And my friends in Downingtown, Sammy and Lisa, they got a place up there for four-wheeling. So, Lisa, Sammy, if you're watching this video, I was up in that neck of the woods where your place is. But it's pretty amazing. I had a great time. So enough of that. I just want to let you guys know I'm alive and well. I didn't forget you guys. I just got sidetracked, if you will. Okay? And on Friday, I had to go and see my family doctor for my routine checkup, a six-month checkup. And they're very happy. My blood pressure was, you know, they're real happy with my blood pressure. It's real close to being perfect, if I can say that, without, hexing myself, you know, or sending me a bad omen. But my weight was down to 179 from 200. So, and they're also happy about that. Matter of fact, the little girl that, you know, checked me all out and all this, I said, can you put that down on a piece of paper for me so I can take it home? And she says, sure. And she put it down on this piece of paper, but she also put this on there, a little smiley face. So, and there it is. If you guys can read that, what is it, 124 over 80? Okay. And there's my weight, so it's all good. It really is. Of course, I got a whole write-up on it, you know. But you guys don't need to see that. But I'm real happy. I really am. And I think today being Saturday, I'm going to take a ride into Mannheim, Pennsylvania. There is a Class C motorhome in Mannheim, and I've been in touch with the gentleman that's selling it, and he said if you want to come down and see it, I will give you, you know, an actual address of where the motorhome is at, which I can't blame him. You know, you don't know who to trust nowadays, you know. But he said as of right now, just say it's in Mannheim, but you get in touch with me and let me know you're coming, and I will give you an actual address. And I said, okay, thank you very much. So I think that's where I'll be going today. If not today, maybe tomorrow. So wish me luck on that. It's a Class C, and I think it's 24 foot, but the picture makes it look a lot bigger. But Class C 24 foot, and it's got about 12,000 original miles on it. I can dig it. All right, enough of that. Birthdays today on Saturday, September the 12th, 2020. It's Jennifer Hudson's birthday today. She's 39 years young. She was born in Chicago, Illinois, and her net worth is about $25 million. Great singer. Next birthday is another Jennifer Nettles. Boy, she got a voice too. She's 46 years young. Did I say Jennifer Hudson was 39 years young? I hope so. Jennifer Nettles is 46 years young. She's with Sugarland, and her net worth is about $20 million. And she was born in Douglas, Georgia. Now, I lived in Georgia. I lived in a little town called Cumming, Georgia. And, of course, in Dahlonega, Georgia. I lived there for a while. Where else down that way? And I worked in Gainesville for a little while. I had a little club in Dahlonega, Georgia. And I also DJ'd at a place down towards Atlanta called Johnny's Hideaway. And I think that's still around. I'm just rambling on here, just to give you an idea that, yes, I've been to Georgia before. But anyway, we're going to do a three-day weather forecast for Douglas, Georgia. And again, as I said, I've never been to Douglas, Georgia. If any of you have ever been there, you know, send me a little detail and background on it. I'll do some research, but if you've been there, you know, send me your reviews on it. Send me what you liked about it, what you didn't like about it. You know, would you go back again? Or, unless you're living there, of course. All right? Okay. Three-day weather forecast for Douglas, Georgia. I'll give you that in 1 minute. Let me put down some coffee. Come on. All right. In Douglas, Georgia, Saturday, 87 for a high, 73 for a low, and partly cloudy. Sunday in Douglas, Georgia, 86 for a high, 73 for a low, and 60% chance of storms, thunderstorms. Keep that in mind if you're over there in Douglas, Georgia on Sunday. Monday in Douglas, Georgia, 86 for a high, 72 for a low, and 40% chance of thunderstorms. So, you know, figure out where you're going to do on Sunday and Monday accordingly, all right? Now, let's go over here to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, which is not far from where I'm hanging my hat right this moment. But in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Saturday, today, 76 for a high, 59 for a low, and partly cloudy. Sunday in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, 81 for a high, 65 for a low, and partly cloudy. Monday in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, 78 for a high, 51 for a low, and partly cloudy again. Now, let's come on over about 40 miles this way, north. Come on over to where I hang my hat for the time being. Since the summer's over now, Tower City, Pennsylvania. Saturday in Tower City, being today, 70 for a high, 55 was lows, nice sleeping weather, didn't need no air conditioner on, and partly cloudy today. So it's 70 for a high today, partly cloudy, and the low was 55. Now Sunday in Tower City, 76 for a high, 59 for a low, and partly cloudy. Monday in Tower City, 73 for a high, 46 for a low, and partly cloudy. So Tower City's not looking too bad. If you want to jaunt up this way, if you're in the area, let me know. You can come on over, have a couple adult beverages. I'll even throw something out on the grill just for us to eat and get to know one another. So that's about it for that. Today is National Video Games Day for you gamers out there, and I know a few. A young man that I used to work with by the name of Chris, he was a notorious gamer, and he probably still is. And Chris, if you're watching this video today, right now, today's your day. Play those video games. Have at it. My son RJ used to be into video games, and I think he still is, but not quite as much as he used to be. Now, the other thing today is National Chocolate Milkshake Day. Now, me personally, when I have a milkshake, I ask for a chocolate milkshake. give me chocolate ice cream and chocolate syrup in it and do it up that way. I want chocolate. I don't want vanilla ice cream and chocolate syrup. I want chocolate. And if you have never had it that way, try it. What I used to have years and years and years ago when I was a young lad and I lived in Exton, Pennsylvania, we had a little bit of a, I think it was called Tasty Freeze. The gentleman that owned the building, his name was Max. He's no longer with us anymore. But he had the Tasty Freeze, and he had a little bit of a general store. You know, well, not a general store. Back then, they didn't have the big Acme's and the Giants and all that. This was just a mom-and-pop store where you could go in and buy your groceries back then. Well, he owned the grocery store, and right next to it, you know, a couple 2,000 feet away, he was his freestanding building, and it was a Tasty Freeze, I think was the name of it. And he used to make, or the person that worked there, or people that worked there, used to make a milkshake there that I used to get. It was called a Boston milkshake. Now, the Boston milkshake, if you guys remember, or at least this is what they taught me and told me when I was eating this from the Tasty Freeze, it would be in a nice big paper, waxed paper cup or whatever you want to call it. But they would do like a milkshake, but then they put a bunch of soft serve ice cream in it with a spoon and a little bit of whipped cream on the top and a cherry, all right, and chocolate syrup on it. And that was called a Boston milkshake. Now, if you guys have different recipes or different versions, let me know. And Jane from over there in Boston, that's where they park the car. Let me know if you ever had any Boston milkshakes. All right, that's all I got, folks. Hope you have a great day today. Hope things are going well for you. Hope you're healthy, safe. Love your family and your kids, because we're not guaranteed tomorrow. And thank you, God, for another day on earth. I thank my God religiously every day, sometimes more than once a day. Yes, I do. And pray to your God to keep your family healthy and safe. Love your family, again, because we are not guaranteed tomorrow. Remember that, okay? Be kind to one another. Do a good deed today for somebody if you can, all right? If you like my video, hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And share this video with your friends and family. And ask them to subscribe to my channel. Normally, I do my good morning videos Monday through Friday, normally, all right? Every once in a while, there's a little bit of a hiccup, but I've been doing this for, 3 years now? So if you're bored, you can just archive all my videos and sit there and watch my videos and drink your coffee or drink your adult beverage, have a libation, whatever the case may be, okay? All right, let's put it down one more time, and I'll talk with all of you guys, good Lord willing, on Monday. On three now. Come on, put it down. Lucille, how you doing? 1, 2, 3. Come on. Ah. To my family out there. My brothers. My sister. My cousins. My nieces. My nephews. My grandchildren. My son. My daughters. My daughter-in-law, my favorite daughter-in-law, Lloyd, how you doing, buddy? That's it. Have a great day today. My RVer friends out there, be healthy and be safe, all right? Wish me luck when I'm looking for this classy RV today. You know, pray to your God that this might be the one, okay? All right, on three, I'm going to punch you guys out. Like I said, don't forget to smell the coffee. And do yourself a favor. Don't save all your good stuff stashed away, you know, for another day. If you got to fine china or fine silverware or whatever. Use it. Enjoy it now. Like Clarence Clemens once said, drink the good wine. Don't save it for a special day. Drink the good wine now. Enjoy it. All right. God bless you guys. I love you. On three, you're going out. Give me a big smile, okay? One, two. Peace. See ya.